Well, hey, everybody, and welcome to The Wrap. I am David Gillette. We are so lucky that Mark Frost agreed to stick around for a few more minutes to talk all things Twin Peaks. Mark, thanks for making more time.
Happy to do it.
So if folks didn't see the show, the reason we wanted you here today is you're releasing the new novel. Give us the brief background on this book sitting here.
It's called The Secret History of Twin Peaks. We had a history of doing books with the old show. We had a book that was quite well known. It was actually a New York Times bestseller for many weeks called The Secret Diary of Laura Palmer, which viewers will remember. And I felt we should do a book to kind of get people ready for the new season. And I wanted to write it. And in the intervening years, I've become a novelist. This is my 12th book. And I thought, I want to apply that skill set to all the material that we developed all those years ago, and this was the result.
So you've spent a lot of headspace in the Twin Peaks universe over all these years. What surprised you about the project's legacy overall?
The number of people who cite it as an influence has always astonished me. People from The Sopranos to Lost to Mr. Robot, which is now going, this show.
Which of those do you buy, by the way? Where do you see influence? Where do you agree?
What David Chase said about The Sopranos was that the freedom to go into sort of less than full reality spaces, to go into characters' dreams, to go into nightmares, to take you into places that weren't just purely objective reality. And he said, you broke down that door for me. Mm-hmm. And that was really an important lesson. Lost, I think they said, because the way that you were able to just not worry about wrapping things up. Obviously, Lost was kind of famous for doing that or not doing that. And then Sam Esmail, who's done Mr. Robot, which I think is an extraordinary show, he said that that was the show he cut his eye teeth on. So it's a lot of people who grew up liking the show. And, you know, if we kick down some doors for people to follow us through, then you can't ask for much more than that.
You mentioned the word nightmares, and that, I think, is one of the flavors you're sort of left with after you've watched the whole series. And yet, I have another clip I want to play, because at least I forgot this until rewatching. There was so much comedy, even slapstick, in this show. So let's take a look at this clip with Andy, and then we'll talk about it.
Harry, it's ancient relic and flowers! Andy, you all right? Andy, are you all right?
That really summarizes it for me, because that's one of the ways Twin Peaks gets in your head. You know, there's this psychological borderline terror to it at times, and yet you're doing stuff like that.
Well, I think it reflected a fuller sense of the full spectrum of what life is. Life is hilarious, and it's terrifying, and it's moving, and it's touching, and it's romantic, and it's all those things. So we tried to create a full kind of smorgasbord there.
And people have projected a lot onto the show, but as one of the guys who created it, I've always wanted to ask you, do you feel Twin Peaks is at its core an optimistic or a pessimistic
That's
show?
A really interesting question. I think there's a tension between the co-creator's worldview. I'm an optimist, and David brings a lot of the dark, scary stuff, and that's obviously a big flavor in a lot of the rest of his work. And I think one of the reasons it was successful is that that was a dynamic tension that never got resolved, but that both were contending to have a point of view. So it's like watching two differing philosophies at work.
David Lynch obviously did pretty famously cameo as Gordon Cole, the head FBI agent.
Right.
Are there any characters in the series that are you?
Well, I had I played a character in
the... I know you had a cameo, but I'm talking more in who you are as a person that kind of went into the
any of
the characters.
Oh, I see what you mean. Yeah, well, there's a good amount of Agent Cooper in me.
Oh, really?
The kind of super rational side to Agent Cooper. And Kyle kind of based his performance in a lot of different things, but some of them were David mannerisms, and some of them were mine, and some were obviously his own inimitable gifts. But so I'd say there's a little bit of me and Coop.
We were talking earlier about your Minnesota connections.
Yeah,
I'm going to say a name here, and I want you to tell me why this name is significant. Okay, Steve Truax.
Steve Truax, one of my best friends from high school.
Oh, you got to wave, Steve. You got to wave. Hi, Steve.
Has worked here for many, many years.
Here at Twin Cities PBS.
Twin Cities PBS.
Yeah, let's clap for Steve. We all love Steve here.
Steve. His house was the neighborhood hangout. His mom was the neighborhood kind of den mother.
Yeah.
She took care of us all, and we've stayed friends over the years. That's Steve.
And his name has made at least a brief appearance in some of your writing work.
Well, in one of the episodes, in fact, I think it's the pilot, there's a scene where Piper Laurie of Twin Peaks, Piper Laurie comes down into the sawmill. You'll remember she ran the sawmill.
Yep.
And there's a guy standing there, and she says, "What's your name?" And I think, is it Fred Truax? He says, "Fred Truax." And she says, "You're fired." It's a little bit of a kind of a prescient look ahead to Donald Trump, I guess.
I want to keep going, but I have to wrap this up. Would you walk with me
of
to
course.
Summarize this segment?
Yeah.
Everyone who's been waiting patiently, you may now have the donuts, so thank you for waiting.
Feel free.
All right, right this
Dive
way,
in.
Mr. Frost. We're going to actually walk out of the studio today.
Yeah.
And you saw this on your way in. That music still, it's in my DNA. I saw the show when I was about 8, and I'll never be able to forget it.
I know.
This is our Wall of Fame. It's going to be noisy out here. So we have a Hamilton musical premiere going on next door, so we'll walk by that. Hi, Hamilton. Our Wall of Fame has a lot of well-known people on here, and we didn't want to miss our chance to get such a prominent Minnesotan up on this wall. So down here in the region of Mr. Kevin O'Connor from This Old House, we have saved a brick for you.
Fantastic.
And so Mr. Mark Frost, on behalf of all the Minnesotans you have entertained and terrified over the years, please sign our Wall of Fame.
I will.
Copyright trouble for this. I love it. And for all the web fans who will text me right now if I don't ask, Showtime, what can you tell me about the new series?
2017.
It's going to happen.
It's going to happen. We don't know exactly when. We don't know exactly how many, but you'll know soon.
And Special Agent David Gillette will make a brief appearance on the show.
He already has.
That's all the time we have for the wrap. We'll see you next week. Thank you so much.